information, so you gon' know. We're sailing at cost, they're doing the Salone. Yeah, yeah. They're cost to do all you, mama. Pleasant good evening and welcome to the 18th edition of Red Cross Na Salone TV show. I am Edward Aloysius Rena. Our viewers, I want to beg your pardon, tonight's show is going to be strictly in English, but of course you'll have chance to listen to some of your actualities in Creole, because the studio guests we have tonight, probably if they speak Creole you will laugh a little. But of course you're watching the Red Cross Na Salone TV show, and tonight's show focuses on the fight against Ebola. Is not over. Ebola stops with me, the big idea of the week, and we hope to bring you in-depth coverage on what is happening at the Tambakula Wharf, Man of War Bay, Aberdeen, and the Dan Strip community in the west end of Freetown. We hope to bring you a minute feature on the role our volunteers are playing in Kenema, and news on Red Cross activities across the country, and lots more. Don't forget, you can add your voices to ours on the show by sending a text message to 078-906-351. Don't forget, you can add your voices to ours on the show by sending a text message to 078-906-351. Well, if it's the first time you're watching the show, the Red Cross Na Salone TV show gives insights on the work of the Sierra Leone Red Cross Society and its partners. It showcases the effort in the fight against Ebola and many other health issues. Tonight, the show will cover the National Ebola Response Center, NAC's big idea of the week, which is the fight is not over. Ebola stops with me, Ebola stops with you watching TV right now. My studio guests tonight are from the International Federation of the Red Cross and Red Crescent, and joining me tonight is Norbert Elali, head of Ebola operations in West Africa. And we all flagged in the IFRC colors and not the national colors tonight. But of course, he is the head of Ebola operations in West Africa. And of course, Christophe Lobry-Blanger, deputy regional head of Ebola operations. And also Andrew Jajua, operations manager of the IFRC response team here in Freetown. Well, tonight we'll be talking about what they're doing in Freetown. The names are very, well, they're not common around here. Then they'll tell you why they're in Sierra Leone and what they're doing here. But we'll start with the interview and the big idea of the week. The fight is not over. Ebola stops with me is this week's big idea, a replication of last week's idea. In light of this, as requested by the acting SG of the Sierra Leone Red Cross Society, our broadcast team went to Kenema, Eastern Sierra Leone, to find out what Red Cross Ebola volunteers are doing. Salone Red Cross Society don't make stronger efforts by the fate within the EPAPA government for fate Ebola all about na the country. As part of Red Cross their efforts, the society don't scatter contact tracer, social mobilization officer, psychosocial counselor, and dede body workman name all about na the country. This na Kenema town. Kenema na the headquarter for the eastern region na Salone. Inside Kenema, like plenty other side them, Red Cross volunteer then the work tranga one for help fight Ebola. Inside we work na Kenema, we be meet with Christiana Kopome, we na one psychosocial counselor, George Philip Jambawai, we na contact monitor, and Aruna Soke Banya, we na one social mobilization volunteer. First, I been talk to the all three, but then work.
Psychosocial support, what it mean, we there for counseling people then, we don't traumatize inside this Ebola scourge. Then we there again for talk to people then, for between two people that we don't get conflict inside this Ebola. So now that kind of support and then we can get out to people there. Inside this work here, me, I feel good. One, because this Ebola we can Salone, it will not be really easy for even me and other people there. Don't me, it not affect me per se. But if I look around again, it affects me because I can say myself be done, they do something. But after when this Ebola come inside, I decide I can't work with Red Cross because I see unnecessary say yes, I for do this because them people there where this thing they affect, or even myself. Now we family there. Now we fumble there. If I see them, they see people that they go astray, they I get that silent thing. I'm not able to share it with people that, or God give me a gift where I'm not able to share it with people that. I left Sidon, people that they go astray, you know, go tell well on me. So I they feel good where I they do this work.
Some people can call them contact tracers, but like we don't redefine them. We are contact monitors. That we now people them, after the surveillance team, where we don't get Ebola case inside, the surveillance team don't interfere, they don't do the line listing. Then they go need people them for go watch after them people and they how then they do. Now through say they don't come down with the sick because we can go to their homes and they will begin to ask them how you sleep. You experience cold, you experience fever, you get headache, we ask them then different questions and then we can note them down. So now through that if we don't get two or more signs where we can present the reports to the office there, they take her up with the DHMT, then they do refer her straight. And they remember where I go to one community as the Mosca break. People that begin run away. Because when the Mosca will use, then they say and say if you buy ambulance, even though he get the Red Cross. So as the Mosca break, people then begin run, then they go to bush. Now we take and say, they get one kind of thinking about Red Cross. So if we left her, we not correct them, it get for damage we expect. So we begin to find out why the people here they run away from Red Cross. Why we for can't break my hair, the people begin run. And then how we go get them back? Now strange place we don't go. And our bush they don't begin run go. Some they enter inside the room, they lock them, they mod them. So that experience they, to me it be awkward. But now the skill where we be used, because not to me one. The success we care about branch don't make not to one person for claimant. Now all the staff and all the volunteers them. Now we don't get this result here, so. So we say let we rest, let we left them made a hide, made a don't for hide. We left them the hide. You understand? Luckily, we get one police there. They will also get their own picking. Now the community will miss and they play ball. And now one of the laws and that would be say public guard will for stop them. Even for play ball, I think they don't put ban for that. So we say if we're going at the football field, they're not run away from we. Now to the first will begin top. So we take 2-3 people then. Among the communities themselves, among them, we use them for talk to the people and we tell them. We talk to them, then listen, we. Now they help we now for go talk to the people. And we then see their own brothers and picking them, and mama, their uncle, they among we, they begin openly the more than they come out. Now they self now begin go at their own bush and now for go call their own brothers and come for can't listen to we. As they talk, the community now one of the best communities now. Every 2-3 days, we go there and make sure how would they do. And they do well now. And the one that we did, they always with them. So that experience that people run away from Red Cross, we able to bring them back, we make them sit down, they listen to we, they contribute greatly or immensely. I think that experience they now be the best. I will make the bad thing that be given by the society, they go off and I replace it with something very good. To them, Red Cross is one of the best organizations right now where they work with.
Social mom like awareness raising, who can go a type of sensitization, can go in our community and sensitize people, follow, get law, educate them. You know, about this dreadful disease, Ebola. Because like me, every hour I be go, people they be go tell me, they even call me sister, and I on. They say, now who they was dead, but you go bury, let's see them. So, what you wish, and you say, the work you don't carry, you don't do the work you don't go, as I decide, they come on here. But that's all no broke, see me for long, continue. I be just find a time one day, I call them together, talk to them, bring them self down. Then at the time we let a doctor, when the most doctor, we all believe doctor can be died. That really calmed them. And the day after the burial, I go down and my host and my community. I call them. I say, oh, and they say, this is not me. This is an example. For say, Dr. Khan, a professor, somebody don't learn, they don't get in paper, a material doctor like that, they don't go. Then I lie, go lie. So straight off, I be fused and they begin to calm me now. At least when I can come home, I go back. They can hear me, they ask me questions. And I go say, a semi-workshop, I can give them. One of the challenges, so again, now the stigma already put down with Ebola. Ebola team, they can say Ebola reporters, you know, really, they can call all kind of. Now, one of the challenges that we can really facing, start to talk in our community as people see they run. You know, like I can remember we go to a village, they don't know semi can talk many, as they were cosmos cutting up, and they say, to our modes. So, when they don't know talk, now I call their attention, we say, talking many, I say, not to so they be, before they begin to come now, and I preach to them. Now, tell them, say, some of them, students, when I get picked up, when I student, they 1 year, we should only go to school. We will continue for the living, they can't see them. Why we go lie? while we go there and pass this and where you country, not to Liberia, we there, we still encourage sickness for the day. So, but the challenge is, and some of you said that they point and power with, but we never look up to that. Among the grammar group, Mickey write songs, I can write what he said. We like 30 times we keep gaining and go. He only write that unfortunate because this particular sickness they encourage, like, you know, put people together and do something. But of course, now Mickey write song for them, I can write on heads, you know, and some of the things. So I feel proud. We no want to see now, Ebola. We don't get spot you, Ebola. We no want for see now, you know, baba disease, you know, fit more time out. We no want for see now, we don't be late, get spot you. We no want for see now, you know, baba disease, you know, fit more time out. Ebola, Ebola, yeah. Yeah, Ebola, yeah.
That same afternoon day, we been Debbie and Christiana Kopome for go na one quarantine host inside Kenematong. This host, na day one Red Cross volunteer nurse believe we been die from Ebola. The late Morris been the work na the Kenema Ebola Treatment Center with the International Federation for Red Cross, the run.
Me na Christiana Kopome, a common Sierra Leone Red Cross. A day this morning, I can't talk to una, especially na day quarantine home say. I can daily forgive psychosocial support and counseling. I for can't talk to una this morning about what we don't pass, especially when we lost with brother when I'm Morrison. We know say you know easy, but we just get for beer with waiting pass. And again, we don't they go along. We lost Morrison in Mama again, not so. I know say it not get for easy with we all Naya we Sidon where they don't even quarantine we. But with the help of God and we where they can't talk to una, I believe say now God now in the give person word for God tell somebody. And I know say if that God did there with we, a day with me this morning, whatever I go tell una Naya una go take her by faith.
Let God put replacements. We go can't wait. What turn out with you? We go pass this. My God, your own grace. Well, sit down here. Then sad. And the thing, say, I'm not getting ending.
The next day, me and my team, been Debian George Philip Jambawai, and one in company, we go now our other host with them quarantine. This host, now there the driver believe, we been take the late Maurice for go hospital. When we reach now the compound, the people be tell we say, not to all my one put in face in a TV, so we not for video them. My cameraman being used in Master Sabi for video na the quarantine host, how we Red Cross workman in the work, and save 2-3 of the people we been grief for put them face.
Now, we don't want to palm them. Our Lord take and say now looking glass, now we get. Looking glass.
Yeah.
Mirror. Now we get, now they watch so. Right?
Yeah.
So now, where this quarantine go done? I want to let you tell me what you see in the mirror, what you want let happen to you. After we got the make, we don't pray this whole process don't come to an end. And we all come out well, but we all come out well, buddy. Just like I said, the mirror where they watch now, na vision. What you don't see in this mirror, what you want let happen to you as the quarantine done so, you don't feel now?
As for me,
yes, sir.
As the quarantine done so, it's a
what did they call the whole thing? What did they
this say? Ebola sat down and the whole country lay down.
Let
everything come to normalcy. And now prayer.
Well, now so get for psychosocial and contact monitor volunteer them. They work Tranga one inside Kenema. Me, na Edward Alusho Sirena. And no, this, now waiting we volunteer them they do inside Kenema. Well, I hope you enjoyed that piece put together by our broadcast team on the work the Sierra Leone Red Cross is doing in Kenema through our volunteers, contact tracing, psychosocial counseling, and a lot more. Well, it's now time for our usual break, and we'll take a short break with episode 10 of the Red Cross na Salone TV drama Advice.
That anybody who don't well from Ebola, not get one problem again.
Tell them.
This we brother we don't cancel. He no go ever get Ebola again.
No go get her.
In there, in a place for let he help we, for let we able know the one day we get Ebola symptoms. So do ya, if anybody sick, una call. 117.
You know, so cancel for the caller.
The other thing which he make with the work, we cancel on them. The, for the neighbor them, we then deny this community. Learn not, they know they pull int. But somebody where they don't go, where the secret will like don't go, they come, they pull int.
So
where
come you pull back, int,
we they arrest you.
That's
true.
And where we arrest you, na jail.
Papa, na sickness.
So I beg, do ya? We not the neighbor them, we not pull int. But this man again. This man not free. Yeah? You are.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
To Red Cross, and now I'll hand over this morning to the woman of the
Una, thank you. Una, thank you. Now that this morning, we got a cook with
no, you. No, not for my food. So now, when you come down to a cross, now I know what it is. Hey, you see what? You, deputy there, then everybody, all, we're all for joining.
You know, talk yourself, Drea, I'll for join you now. Because Mr. Steph won't join here.
We'll go there.
We'll go there.
I'll submit the address.
You'll submit the address. Auntie, Mr. Steph will join.
Well, that was Advice Episode 10, and it was talking about stigmatization. I'm sure you captured the information in that drama series. I'm sure you now know what to do and what not to do to our survivors who regard as our heroes. While we continue the show, you're watching the Red Cross Salone TV show, coming to you live from the Sierra Leone Broadcasting Corporation, courtesy of the Sierra Leone Red Cross Society. The International Federation of the Red Cross and Red Crescent has just completed the meeting here in Freetown on, the meeting which ended today at the Family Kingdom Resort in Freetown provided experience sharing platform for delegates working in all the three countries, Sierra Leone, Liberia, and Guinea, and on all of the pillars in the fight against Ebola. Like I mentioned earlier, joining me in the studio to talk about the workshop and the work of the FRC is Norbert Alali. He is the head of regional operations, and of course, Christopher Lobe Bollinger. Well, like I mentioned earlier, the name is not common, so I keep. Well, of course, Christoph is also here, and Andrew Jajua is also here, and Andrew Jajua is the operations manager of the IFRC response team here in Sierra Leone. But let me start welcoming once more again. Good evening, gentlemen. Mm-hmm. And I'll start with good you, evening. Norbert. What necessitated the meeting?
Thank you. And I'm greeting the community of Sierra Leone and those who are watching this broadcast. We have this meeting regularly in affected countries where we brought delegates from all three countries affected to discuss cross-border issue because we are sharing same challenges from how and also this outbreak is affecting our community. You know, people, they have family across the border, mm-hmm. and we have a lot of movement for population. People are going back, and we need to as a humanitarian actor, we used to meet and talk about those issues, and also to build the capacity of our team to address questions they have and challenges they have. We bring everybody together to try to find solutions.
Okay.
That's the purpose of the meeting.
Okay. What was the main thrust of this meeting, the one which ended today?
Today we come up with a great outcome. That means Ebola is not over.
Okay.
We have to keep the momentum. We have to maintain our capacity and to work in close collaboration with Sierra Leone National Society, Red Cross National Society, and also to engage with the community, because as you said at the beginning, Ebola, we cannot be free of Ebola without anybody. We have to do it together. And the second thing we come up after this meeting is that we need also more resources, because the fight still continues until we get to zero case, not only in Sierra Leone, but in our region.
Okay.
That's it.
Okay, now that brings me over to you, Christoph. How does such a meeting impact on the efficiency of the IFRC within the sub-region?
Well, it is important to have... Good evening, first of all, and thank you very much for inviting us to speak. It is important to have regional gathering like this of the response against the fight against Ebola. For the simple reason that if you have a few cases or one case of Ebola in one country, basically the countries of the regions are at risk or affected. And this is why we want to make sure that there's a regional approach, not just a country approach, which of course is very efficient and is working quite well, but also that we have a regional approach to the fight against Ebola. And this is why, from time to time, we like to gather all the three countries, the affected countries, in the same room, in the same facility, to talk amongst ourselves, the three countries, with regards to specific elements to the fight against Ebola.
Okay, speaking of specific elements within the fight, I'm sure there are some challenges that you faced with when you were going about doing your job within the sub-region. Do you want to share that with our viewers, some of the challenges?
Well, one of the challenges that we face, whether it is in this country, in Sierra Leone, but also in Guinea, and also in Liberia, has been from time to time some community resistance.
Okay.
And lack of understanding about the nature of the virus, the nature of the outbreak, and also perhaps at times the lack of support with regards to the actions of the Red Cross. And this is why it is important to make sure that the communities understand
Okay. The
nature of the virus itself, the nature of the outbreak, but also understand what the Red Cross does in the fight against Ebola.
Okay.
And programs such as this one explain very well what Ebola is, but also what the actions taken by the Red Cross are. This is one of the challenges that we have faced at times, and this is one of the ways that we have faced and confronted this challenge and found solutions.
Now that brings me to you, Andrew. What impact do you think this workshop that has just ended will have on the work you guys are doing here in Sierra Leone?
Yeah, thank you very much, Edward. Good evening and welcome my colleagues to the show. Going back to situations like emergencies, yeah, as you rightly know, that Sierra Leone Red Cross Society is a member of the International Federation of Red Cross and Red Crescent Societies.
Yeah.
And part of the functions of the Federation is to support national societies in cases of need, in case of emergencies, particularly when the situation exceeds the capacity of the national society. And this is why we're here. And looking at the impact of the support of the Federation, you know, we have an ETC, that's the Ebola Treatment Center in Kenema, and another one in Po, and they are doing extremely well. And recognizing the fact that your national society is a very well-functioning national society. However, irrespective of the good work the national society have been doing, they need support to raise their capacity, to build their capacity, enforce their capacity to be able to do more to this, to the communities. So this meeting is also contributing towards the efforts of the Federation in resource mobilization.
Okay.
As you can see, we have raised financial resource, financial mobilization, as well as logistic mobilization for the operations in this country.
Okay.
And this is creating a big impact in the response efforts of the national society.
Okay, now tell us, you've been in Sierra Leone for quite some time now, and you've been monitoring the work the National Society is doing, of course, with support from the IFRC. What can you say about that? Do you see them getting there in terms of helping this government put Ebola to rest?
Yeah, I think they're doing very well. As I said, they're doing very well. And the National Society is present nationwide. That is, in every district, you have the branch of the branch of the National Society, and also present in most of the communities in chiefdoms, you can see the Red Cross operating. And there is that sort of trust and confidence from the people. When they have confidence in you, they will listen to you, and they will provide the services that you need to help them. And this is the characteristics of the Sierra Leone Red Cross Society. It's doing well in terms of community engagement activities, and the Federation is supporting them in all ventures to be able to combat this emergency.
Okay. Now, coming back to you, Norbert, the challenges we just mentioned, of course, Christopher just said that there are some challenges in what you do, especially people not accepting. Of course, we also heard from the guys who are in the field that there are times they've been stigmatized. They call them Ebola Red Cross officers, Red Cross Ebola people, and all of this. How do you hope to tackle these challenges as head of operations in the sub-region?
Well, you know, when comes time to work with community, it's not common to have the same understanding. You have people who can understand what we're doing, those who are not understanding. And for Federation and the National Society, Red Cross for Sierra Leone, we are putting such TV show to have the platform to talk to people, to explain what we are doing, and also to give them a voice, to listen to them, to get feedback, to help them to ask questions, and we can answer. That's one thing we are doing. And also for this challenge, one topic of our discussion is how we do better what we are doing, how we improve this, how we build the capacity of our volunteers in the field who are the one at the front line of this fight against Ebola. And we come up with some solution that we need to keep the momentum of our crew and have them engaged, because without them, we don't have power.
Okay.
Volunteers are the power of our organization, and we keep the momentum and we motivate them.
One of the strengths of the National Society is its volunteers.
Yeah.
And we are contributing a lot by providing training services, giving them the opportunity to learn more and to know more, because it is a very big issue in terms of responding to the needs. Mm-hmm. So therefore, training volunteers, identifying staff that are exclusively responsible for this operation, the joint effort gives more confidence to the staff, to volunteers, and to the National Society as a whole to be able to confront whatever challenges they might face in the field. So the training and the capacity building that we are contributing towards the efforts of the National Society has a big impact, and is also contributing enormously in whatever the National Society, Sierra Red Cross Society, is doing in this country.
Okay.
And in most of it is highly recognized.
Okay. Christoph, is this the same in Liberia and Guinea?
It is important to stress that one of the functions of the International Red Cross and Red Crescent Societies is to bring the strength of 189 national societies to support that particular national society in this country.
Okay.
In the present case, the Sierra Leone Red Cross and Red Cross Society. It is important for the volunteers to know that the entire world is supporting them, that you have delegates coming from the region, that delegates coming from the continent, that delegates coming from Asia, from Europe, to support them. And it is important for those volunteers here locally to know that they're not alone, and the world cares about what they're doing, and cares about the importance of what they're doing. And this is why we're coming, this is why we're here, to support them.
Okay.
That voice is important.
Okay, gentlemen, could you just tell me, I'll come right back to you. When we come back, we will definitely be talking about plans for post-Ebola and lots more. But let's join my colleague, Sylvester Fumba, who's been taking down your text messages. Fumba?
Good evening, Mr. Arena. Confirmed cases for today, 28 February 2015. Bombali, 5. Potloko, 3. Western Area Urban, 6. Western Area Rural, 4. Tuta, 18. This first text message says, thank you very much, Red Cross, on your substantial efforts to eradicate this dreadful enemy called Ebola. This one comes from Bullet from Sammy Town. Red Cross, thank you very much for the program. From Concerned Citizen. Also, this one says, no matter what the Red Cross does against the fight against Ebola, the people of Sierra Leone should come together and work as one so as to put this epidemic behind us. Coming from a Concerned Citizen as well. Also, we are having cases coming up every day. Do you think we are going to end the Ebola fight easily with the lawlessness of people in the city? This one is coming from Abu Bagu of Private Eye. The last one says, special thanks and appreciation to the Red Cross staff for their efforts in the fight against Ebola in Sierra Leone. They have given enough participation in the burial of Ebola victims. This one comes from a concerned citizen as well. Thanks for now and back to you, Mr. Reyna.
Many thanks to you, Fumba. Of course, keep sending your messages to 0789063 51. That's the number, 0789063 51, and we'll read them as we go along. But first, let's look at the text messages we just received. What's your perception about what you've just had from people watching the TV show outside, not just in Freetown but outside Freetown also?
It's a good indicator that the work Red Cross is doing here in Sierra Leone is well perceived by people and well appreciated, and we are happy to hear that.
Mm-hmm.
That community are with us, and they know what we are doing and they appreciate, and this is helpful. And I will take this opportunity to thank the Sierra Leone National Society and the network of volunteers, partners for what we are doing. We are grateful. We know that it's not easy, but they are there, and the Red Cross is always there.
Mm-hmm.
When it's becoming difficult, and we will be there even after Ebola. People, they are using this opportunity to talk to Red Cross.
Mm-hmm.
And Red Cross is also talking to people. That is the best way to communicate and to succeed in this fight against Ebola, and encouraging people to continue and to feedback us on what they're feeling, what good idea they have, what suggestion they have to help us to improve what we're doing.
Okay. Now, Christoph, somebody asked a question about, do you think we're really getting to zero when people are starting showing some signs of complacency, thinking that the fight is over when it's not yet over?
This is important to understand that even with one case or a few cases of Ebola, the whole country and the whole region is at risk. It is important to understand that we should not be complacent, and we should not let our guards down. In concrete terms, what does it mean? That means that we should keep washing our hands at the entrance of buildings. We should keep welcoming people who take our temperature. We should keep watching for signs of either fever or the symptoms of Ebola.
Mm-hmm.
And we should keep being mindful of the measures which are being promoted by the Red Cross and by the government to prevent Ebola from spreading. But once someone might have Ebola or might have symptoms of Ebola, to immediately take the measures which are in place to prevent from the disease to spread further.
Okay. Yes, Andreas, you want to make a point?
Yes. Yes, the work of the Red Cross is to support humanitarian work, humanity.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what we are here for, irrespective of the country. And this is the same work we are doing in Liberia, in Guinea, and in Sierra Leone, the three most affected countries.
Mm-hmm.
As far as the Ebola is concerned. And it's good to know that we in Sierra Leone, there are a lot of success stories. And success stories should be shared. And the National Society is sharing these success stories. You have seen on the TV, you have seen on the activities, all the survivors, all these people that are being discharged from ETCs. And these are all success stories, both from the government sides, all the humanitarian partners, the Red Cross. There's a collective effort in trying to combat this disease.
Mm.
And there are a lot of success stories that can be disseminated to other countries where there is no Ebola, for instance, or to other countries where they are doing well, where they need to do more, or we can also learn from other nations or other countries where they have also done a lot of good services. All this is geared towards eradicating this disaster. It's going to be a daunting task, but we will be there one day.
Okay. Norbert, can you share with our viewers what your plans are for post-Ebola in the three countries?
Well, we are hoping that soon we will be free of Ebola. All our countries will be free of Ebola. And we start thinking about recovery, how we go back to the normal life, how we help communities to work for the development of the countries, have all families with enough means to be able to survive and to have fun. And this recovery component, we started already. We have an international team coming in and working in all affected countries. Right now, we have the team in Sierra Leone working closely with the National Society and other partners to find, to assess how much Ebola affects this country and what can be done to start recovering, to start pulling back the normal life for the community in affected countries.
Okay, that brings me over to you, Andrew. You're the guy in town, the man in Sierra Leone. Now tell us, how long will IFRS stay in Sierra Leone? I'm sure some people will be craving to know.
Our function is, as I said before, is to improve or enhance the capacity of the national society. We're not only supporting them to respond to this disaster. Any other emergencies that this country suffers, the Red Cross, the National Society should be able to respond. So our presence here will be as long as the services is needed, as long as the National Society needs the support of the Federation, needs the support of the partners, and needs the support of our collaborators in trying to support, in trying to do what they're doing. So we'll continue to support, we'll continue to contribute towards their response effort in this country as far as required.
Okay. Of course, Christoph, you've just heard what Andrew just said, and he says they'll be as long as they're needed. In other words, there are other things they'll be supporting. Is that the same for Liberia and Guinea?
Yes. At the regional level, or for the other countries, the affected countries, the thinking is similar. Precisely, there's a reflection that has been made in terms of what is the future of the healthcare structure in those countries,
okay,
including Sierra Leone, but also in Liberia, but also in Guinea. And given this vision of what the future of the healthcare structure in that country is, what would be the role of the Red Cross?
Mm-hmm.
And where would the Red Cross fit in? How would it contribute to the future of the country?
Okay.
And this is part of the reflection that we went through over the past few days, to try to define for ourselves what are going to be the steps that we would like to take,
mm-hmm,
within the context of the future of the country.
Okay, so what are some of the tools you're using to get to the communities, get their response, get feedbacks to them, and let them understand that they're not standing alone in the cold?
If you think about the post-Ebola period, which, as my colleague Norbert said, we hope will come as soon as possible, we are mindful that other outbreaks could start, such as cholera, measles, and a few others. And we want the national society to be ready and to have the capacity to respond. And we want to support the national society in terms of having the means and the tools with the community and in presence in the community to be able to help and assist if there is the next cholera outbreak, if there is the next measles outbreak.
Okay. Andrew, you in Sierra Leone, tell us, the people of Sierra Leone may want to know, the rains will set in a few months from now, and during the rains, that's when we experienced cholera. The last time we had a very deadly outbreak of cholera. How do you intend to build the capacity of the national society to handle such instances? We're not praying for any of such to happen, but outbreaks are just the epidemics, they happen, they do happen.
As I said, the Sierra Leone Red Cross Society is quite well experienced. They did a lot of work during the past cholera outbreak,
mm-hmm,
and they're doing the same thing in this outbreak, this disease. And putting all this experience together gives them knowledge and tasks to combat any other situation they might be confronted with. And as we always say, a Sierra Leone Red Cross Society in any given situation will not be left alone. You have the International Federation of Red Cross and Red Crescent Societies, you have got partners, and you have got the ICRC, you have got all this part of the movement that is behind them to support whenever the need arises. The Federation will be here to support the National Society. So all efforts are recognized and will continue to push hard to support for them, they are playing an auxiliary role. Okay. They are an auxiliary to the government, and the national society is, as I said, will be here to stay. We will go in federation. We will go in once in a while coming, but the national society is here to stay, and their responsibility is to support efforts of the government in any given situation, particularly in emergency situation. Mm-hmm. They'll be here always to provide the services, mm-hmm. and we are ready to support them, and they will understand that they are not alone.
Okay.
And we're here to work with them and to provide the services as long as, I said, as much as it is needed, we are ready to work with them.
Okay, we're chasing the hour, and thank you, gentlemen. Do continue to stay with me. We're going for a short break. When we come back, we'll bring you the news, and after which we'll continue to banter on the work and the support from the IFRC to national societies, not just in Sierra Leone, but also in Liberia and Guinea. We'll take a short break.
The Sierra Leone Red Cross Society has been working over the years, and now it's working even more harder than usual. We are presently making our efforts in the fight against Ebola in Sierra Leone worth its while. We engage in contact tracing, dead body management, psychosocial support, providing treatment for Ebola patients. We provide social mobilization, awareness raising through our beneficiary communicators and social mobilization volunteers, amongst many others. Our psychosocial and contact tracing teams are engaged in monitoring quarantine homes, providing counseling, and reuniting survivors with their families and communities that are often proven hostile to Ebola survivors in Freetown and around the nation. We train volunteers to efficiently manage dead bodies, and our burial teams have proven efficient in providing safe burials, which was a problem since the start of the Ebola epidemic. The Red Cross Treatment Center in Kenema, established on 13 September 2014, provides treatment for Ebola patients. It is the very first to provide a separate holding center for children. Our beneficiary communicators and social mobilization volunteers have been upbeat, providing life-saving information and data collection in every community. The Sierra Leone Red Cross Society is making a volunteer out of every Sierra Leonean, and it's giving voice to voiceless Ebola survivors through its television program, the Red Cross Na Salone TV show, and the Red Cross Na Salone radio program on the Sierra Leone Broadcasting Corporation television and radio every Monday and Saturday. Sierra Leone Red Cross Society, helping to make Sierra Leone a better place.
Well, I'm sure that breaker has been able to teach you about some of the stuff we're doing in other parts of the country. Remember, Red Cross is in all districts in Sierra Leone, and our volunteers are deep into every community, and they're doing a lot of work, not just with Ebola, but of course with other situations that are occurring there. We deal with emergencies, so we are continuing with the program. You're still watching the Red Cross show on SLBC TV, and we'll now move over to Abata Thomas for this week's news.
Good evening. This Red Cross user Salone. Good evening to you, Alberta Millicent Thomas. The International Federation for Red Cross and Red Crescent don't done 1-2 days border technical meeting inside Freetown for look inside the way and manner our Salone Red Cross don't help Salone inside the Ebola affects Liberia and Guinea. This meeting also done today on February 28th in a Family Kingdom Resort Freetown. Usa even get Master Sabi people that we get for engage and talk plenty about the Mano River Basin and save the pillars the way they inside the Ebola fet. As Aliu Boyle, one of the Guinean country representative and the IFRC Ebola response team in Guinea, we get for the inside this training and we get for see something.
same country. There is no difference between Liberia, Sierra Leone, Guinea, have same communities. The borders are not really natural borders that can show difference. No, everything that is happening here is also to be expected in the other side of the border. So there's a real, it's not a need, it's mandatory to meet its order to coordinate our effort. And this is what the Red Cross movement is improving through the organization of these cross-border technical meetings. The second aspect is that has technical meeting, this is an opportunity to share the best practices, to learn from each other, and also to support each other, because the work that all of the interveners are doing in this operation is not easy. Two things. First, these three countries, in fact, it's the same country.
Well, that's Nabi Aliou Boy, one of the Guinean representatives from the IFRC Ebola response team in Guinea, when they talk. Salone Red Cross Society done 1 3-day workshop, but Ebola operation review inside border and the southern part of Salone. Henry Conte been there, and at this, he been here for 7 4 weeks.
The workshop na been for look inside the work where the society don do and still they do inside Ebola fete. Where it be the talk for the workshop, Acting Secretary General for the Sierra Leone Red Cross Society, Mr. Constant H.S. Kagbo, say the workshop na tranga one way not for FIBA, then one way don't pass.
But this is a workshop with a difference. Most of the workshops we've been in the past is related to a program or something. This is why we are here, and I hope we'll do our best. We'll take out those good things and that has happened in the current Ebola operations. We'll look at the challenges. We'll try to find solutions to those challenges. And we'll also try to recap on the shared concept and see how best we can prepare.
President for the society, Mr. Tamba Edward Gandhi, we himself talk na the opening ceremony, say the workshop go help for give strength to the society. He say people not for take am light, because if they hold the workshop with two hands, Red Cross go get Master Sabi for face the Ebola virus disease recovery assessment team we get for camp na Salone for camp find out what in Red Cross don't do with the Ebola couple.
We catalog your successes and your failures so that we can build on your successes and improve on where you have failed. It's also important that we prepare for this assessment team that is coming. I would say that assessment team really is going to determine our future.
The workshop we done Thursday evening time be being together. Red Cross will command them now the 14 operational area then at the whole country. Usai Red Cross don't work. As all this they be, Sierra Leone Red Cross, they continue for help government for fight Ebola. For Red Cross, na Salone TV News, mean.
Fambul, na so the workshop been talik. 11 Red Cross volunteer them nurse. We have been undergo the quarantine process inside Kenema for Seka, where they may fear not one of their colleagues don't be the work test been confirmed say a positive from the Ebola sick and get for loss in life. Don't the quarantine process inside Kenema town at the eastern partner Salone. Inside this term year so, we are in the contact being get for talk to some of their nurses there will be undergo the quarantine process, and this now it is some of them get for seen.
We work for the emergency treatment center run by IFRC and Sierra Leone Society. And be a difficult time, a very difficult time for Sudan One Place for 42 days in the CU family. It came about as a result of a colleague who become infected, and we render help to that colleague there, and the colleague died later and the test proved positive. So the Federation and the National Society then decide for quarantine me and so that we go observe you for see if anyone among you will be symptomatic. But we thank God that during the 42 days, the first 21 days, a colleague
among we the show symptoms, signs and symptoms, so the surveillance team, the IFRC and the cellular report will pick up quick and then able for their treatment. And that we thank God that we have positive things in that quality. Don't discharge in our house now. And unfortunately for we, we've been there for start the 21 days back.
This is Dr. Ebola Shaka. I'm a nurse and I work for IFRC at the Emergency Treatment Center. We work on 4 days, making 5 days, now we get slight fever. So, when I get this fever, then after 2 days, now I see boil on my leg. This boil here, they give me fever. Although I be they take medication, they take paracetamol, but still they give me fever. So, Mr. and I explain the we head nurse, as soon as the condition. He said, well, if that is the case, then I'll call the center manager. Lord tell us that so this don't happen. So then therefore call the center manager. He said, well, that mistake will be don't do. Lord will not do it again. He said, look, okay, this woman go on ETC, let her go test her. But luckily for me, surveillance team then come inside. They say, well, the way we see this woman is like that boy again this fever. So the best thing what we will do for her, Lord test them. Lord call team, let them take a sample now. They can take me 4 samples, they can go, it'll be negative. After 2 days, maybe 3 days, they can't take my other sample, they get it be negative. So.
Well, Fambul, this now, what's in the Red Cross bring to you inside this week? Your Red Cross na Salone program we come to you live from Salone Broadcasting Corporation. And we will bring on to you the Alberta Thomas. Over to Alicia Serena.
Well, many thanks to you, Alberta, and we'll continue on the show. Of course, my Fambul out there, I believe, say, we not take all Tinayan inside English. You get chance for your use. Bank Rio as usual. Well, we'll continue with the show. You're watching the Red Cross na Salone TV show coming to you live from the Sierra Leone Broadcasting Corporation. And we're moving over to our guests again. And let me come back to you, of course, Head of Operations Regional. That's you, Norbert. Norbert, the thing about getting to zero is what plays now in Sierra Leone. And just late yesterday, the government came out with a press release going back to some of the things they removed where complacency started to creep in. Do you think it's wise to go back to all those tough and rigid things that will get the people to understand that Ebola is still here?
Yeah, of course. We have to go back to all this. As Christopher said, until we get to zero, if you have one case in our region, we have to keep all the measures. And this is not a Red Cross affair, it's individual affair. We have to understand that without me, we cannot kick out Ebola. We have to do it together. Personal prevention is collective prevention. And the government is right to ask people to go back to the prevention measure. And passing this message to Sierra Leone community and those who are watching us, that there's no way to give place to fatigue. Keep up, be alert, watch around yourself, inform Red Cross people, they are everywhere, they can assist you. If you have questions, ask Red Cross people or others agencies who are working against Ebola. We need to maintain and continue to maintain until we get zero in West Africa.
Okay. Yes, Andrew?
Yes, and also to our fellow volunteers and staff, particularly those working on safe and dignified burial teams. It is important that they continue to follow the protocols. Then as Noah's saying, and you're saying, is there's no place for complacency.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore the protocol, the practice, the safe method of doing their job must be followed to the letter at all times and at all circumstances.
Mm-hmm.
And I urge all volunteers to keep up that sort of momentum, as well as other volunteers in social mobilization, beneficiary communication,
mm-hmm.
and contact tracing, as well as psychosocial support. All these volunteers must follow the protocols accordingly.
Okay. Well, I think there's not enough time to look at the final set of text messages. Because of time, I want to say Big thank you to you guys for joining us tonight. Many thanks to you, of course, my studio guests have been Norbert Lally, head of Ebola operations, and of course Christophe Lobe Bolinga, of course, deputy regional head of Ebola operations, and Andrew Chajua, operations manager, IFRC in Sierra Leone. I've been your presenter, Edward Alicious Renner. Many thanks to my producers, Patrick Masakoi, and my executive producer, Mr. Bakar Tarawali, and line producer, Willie Silvanus Collier. Thanks to George Shepherd, who's been doing controls, along with Suleiman Samura, and my camera guy in studio, James Cocker. And thanks to Abata and Sylvester for joining us tonight. So we'll hang out on the same dial next Saturday. Have a blessed evening.